Yes, you sit here.
I will call everybody to stand up for the national anthem. If you check the second page, you will see the national anthem there. So, please, let's be up standing. At the count of three, we'll take the national anthem. One, two, and three. Arise, O compatriots, Nigeria's Kobe, to serve with love and strength and faith. I labor for him. Those past shall never be. is the chairman of the planning committee of this event. So, Rotarian Evis of Baseke, please. Please let me call on Rotarian Ikiru for the opening prayer before we continue.
Good evening, distinguished senator, fellow Rotarians, and our good friends here. We have something we call Rotary Grace, or Rotary Prayer. And that's what we're going to take, inspire Rotarians. Can we be upstanding, please, to do this? Okay. Please, if you have this, if you have the Night of Tributes program, you see it on page one, on the top. Okay, page two on the top left, Rotary Prayer. Inspire Rotarians, Lord, we ask, want to go. Inspire Rotarians, Lord, we ask, to live as we professed. To dignify our daily task and serve in selflessness. Oh, fellowship which here we share, we offer thanks to thee. We pray that it will be our care to spread it bounteously. Amen. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Rotarian Ikiru. So, I will call on the chairman of the planning committee, Rotarian Evis of Baseke, for the welcome, tribute, and recognition.
My president. Good evening, my dear most distinguished Senator Francis Alimikena, district governors, past presidents of the Club of True, fellow Rotarians, our district governor-elect nominee, fellow Rotarians, and our friends, especially the children of our dear senators, Monica Alimikena. My dear fellow Rotarians, we have with us this evening, leading the pack, the oldest of the PDGs in the house, past district governor, Eddie Ifeanyichukwu Mbadiwe, and his lovely spouse, Ijoma. We also have with us another past district governor Felix, to have on the left flank, another past district governor who came all the way from Jos, past district governor and seated to PDG Evis immediate right. One of our incoming governors, district governor-elect Mike Owanoshiri. He also came in from Jos. And to PDG Elvis's immediate left is another incoming governor of our district, district governor nominee Princess Joy Okoro. And We have with long list of AROCAM past presidents. And the oldest in the house this evening is past president and also past assistant governor, O.C. Imomo, and his spouse, Rotarian Victoria Imomo. We also have with us past district, past assistant governor, and also a past president of the Road Club of Abuja Metro, our first female president, Princess Eneka Atwayan. And immediately after Atwayan is another past president of the club, Obi Iyazo. And after Obi Iyazo is another female president of the club, Rotarian Dupe Abosede. And after Dupe is the immediate past president of the club, Rotarian Ifai Anodu. And this evening, to pilot the affairs in the absence of our president, in the absence of our incoming president, President-elect Joseph Okakia. Finally, on the, we also have the assistant governor representing our district governor, Dr. James Agbonise. My dear fellow Rotarians and members of the Rotary Club of Abuja Metro, do me a favor by just being upstanding to give our host and the family of Senatress Monica Alimikena a standing ovation by us standing to be recognized as the members of the club that are here. Thank you. We have some, please you can be seated. We have some persons that joined us from other sister clubs in the district. I will only just call on the names of two and I'll recognize the others together. We have the president of the Rotary Club of Abuja Meitama, and she is also the presidents of clubs in the FCT, Rotarian Ijoma Agu. And another very close friend of the house, and she used to be a member of the Rotary Club of Abuja Metro, past assistant governor Nkiru Nnama. She has ported already now to Gariki Abuja. And all the other visiting Rotarians, please honor us by being upstanding for us to recognize and appreciate you for joining us this evening. Rotarians are not Abuja Metro members. Please just be upstanding to be appreciated. Thank you very much. Rotarians that are visiting, Rotarians that are here, we all know why we are here. A solemn gathering and what we will not wish for. But we all know that there is a debt that we are all waiting to pay. At different times in our that debt will be paid. We have with us our host, who incidentally is also a member of the Rotary Club of Abuja Metro. I will give our dear most distinguished Senator Francis Alimikena the honor not to stand as an AROCAMite evening, but to stand only as our host. My most distinguished Senator, if you want to stand, we allow you ovation. That is our own dear Senator Francis Asekame Alimikena. And I don't think Honorable John will be sitting when Daddy is standing. A son of our dear Senators and OC also, okay, Gregory. Thank you, and we say we appreciate you for opening your doors to us this evening. My most distinguished, we are indeed blessed to be with you. The second reason why I am for you, I will take as a very short note, but not without not only the gentlemen of the press, but the friends of the family of the Alimikena family that are with us. Please, all the friends and members of the family, aside the three that first stood up, please stand up for us to indeed recognize you for your presence this evening. Thank you. Thank you. And thank you. My welcome to goes thus. I've tried to make it very short, but it was difficult, but I will try. Words fail me, though reality finally sunk in, and a tiny bit and drops, that earth has lost an invaluable and priceless gem to the heavenlies. The sad news came and hit up the thunderbolt. 21st of June, when in our dear club, we experienced a most silent birthday from our dear senatress, Monica Alimikena. This was absolutely unlike her. But for me, I waited impatiently for her response to the avalanche of goodwill messages and felicitations on our camp platform, but it never came on that 21st of June. And as I'm used to whenever to reach her, I practically put my phone on auto-redial to just get her attention on that blessed day so that I can wish her happy birthday the way she will also wish you happy birthday on your own day. But our dear senators and jewel of inestimable value to the Oracle of Development and Promise Keeper of Edo Nation, never return those calls. In my restless but caring spirit, hearing from Senator Alimikena the very next day at Agenebude, that same day at Agenebude, rested my thoughts when he said she was in Abuja. But that trademark SMS that mommy will always send between the hours of 11 and 3, 4 a.m. in the morning, the SMS never came. But I kept calling her because her silence was no longer making one easy. Until that treasured moment, and I can't forget that evening on the 17th of July, when she picked at about 3 and she said, "Elvis, where are you?" I said, "I was in Abuja." She said, "Start coming." To come at 3 p.m. would have made our president not join because he was still at work. So I delayed his 6. And I called the president, his wife, one of our past presidents, and 2 other members, and our president-elect and his wife. And we all came down to see Lady Monica Alimikena. It was right in front of this place. We ran into Senator, and he was also coming in. Senator now said, "Mama was not in." The others were already turning back. But I now faced Senator, and I said, "Senator, not be you. We can't look for." It now dawned on him that night that, okay, we knew that Mama was waiting for us, and he ushered us in. Can I ever forget that day? Can time or tides ever erase that opportunity created by that invitation, ever go off our memories? And in her usual charming and cheerful way, we met upstairs, exchanged banters. She had with us so much joy as we serenaded her. That moment will remain evergreen in the hearts of those that were part of that visit. Mama, I would have been at the sentry right here if I knew that trip she said she was making the next day was her last journey out of Nigeria and onto her creator. I swear that I would have been a willing to if she had God's date to keep with her maker. I would have seized every humanly possible opportunity to dispense service to a heart of gold wrapped in Vekuna wool if I knew she was heaven bound. She was indeed rarity in creation and simplicity in personified. Her memories shall remain wrapped in the fiber of God and kept in the vault of our hearts. Our dear senatress remains a pride to motherhood and a beacon to womanhood. Dear senatress, only heaven knows why the visas of the righteous pass so quickly. She has indeed returned home to her creator. Our hearts and eyes, though earthly, are blinded by the pains and wells of tears. But we know that angels in their celestial realm are celebrating the homeward journey of another righteous fellow. My dear most distinguished, the pain is undoubtedly incredible, but Senatress created so many memories worth treasuring. May you always feel surrounded by our love as you continue to feel the incredible impact of our enviable life. She lived very well. In our times of sorrow, love, prayers, support, and the cherished memories provide some measure of comfort and succor for you and your family, sir. Lady Monica meant a lot to a lot of people. She was indeed a truly beautiful and wonderful soul. Say farewell to an amazing and a passionate Rotarian. I say passionate, a passionate Rotarian. A loving wife, loving mother, caring grandma, and our dear lady, Monica Alimekena, that we nicknamed Senatress in the Rotary Club of Abuja Metro for so many reasons. I stand here on behalf of myself and my family that put this together to say fare thee well to one of Nigeria's greatest. Fare thee well to a volunteer par excellence. Thank you. God bless you.
Thank you, Rotarian Obaseki. Yes, we will take the first song, first Christian song, which is on your page, on page 2. What a friend we found we have in Jesus. Catholic Hymn Book 302. So let me call on Rotarian Jennifer to lead that song. Can you come over, please?
Let's be upstanding.
What a friend we have in Jesus. All our sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. Oh, what peace we often forfeit. Oh, what needless pain we bear. All because we do not carry everything to God in prayer. Have we trials and temptation? Is there trouble anywhere? We should never be discouraged. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Oh, can we find a friend so faithful who will all our sorrow share? Jesus knows our every weakness. Take it to the Lord in prayer. God with a load of care. Precious Savior, till I refuge, take it to the Lord in prayer. Oh, do your friends despise, forsake you? Take it to the Lord in prayer. Take it to the Lord. In His hand, He'll take and shield you. You will find no solace there. Amen.
Thank you. You have to wait. We will take the first rotary song. It's a small word.
Okay.
It's a world of laughter, a world of tears. It's a world of hope and the world of fears. There's some more that we share, that it's time we're aware. It's a small world after all. It's a small world. It's a small world after all. It's a small world after all. It's a small world after all. It's a small, small world. There is just one moon and one golden sun, and a smile means friendship to everyone. Though the mountains divide and the oceans divide, it's a small world after all. It's a small world. It's a small world after all. It's a small world after all. It's a small world after all. It's a small, small world.
Thank you.
Thank you, Rotarian Jennifer and First Lady. We now have the petition from our past district governor, Rotarian Felix Obada.
Distinguished Senator Francis Ali Mekena, the children of, there are two lines in that rotary prayer. It says, to live, confess, and serve. The object of rotary is to encourage and foster the ideal of service as a basis of worthy enterprise. A life of service to humanity, a life of selfless service. And the second motto of Rotary, it profits most that serve the best. Rotary gives us the opportunity to truly give back to the society. Senatress Monica exploited that to the very, very highest level. Opportunity to give back to the society. She leveraged the great impact of Rotary in a way that individuals on your own, you can't do as much as when you do it on the platform of Rotary. Successive presidents of our club will testify to that fact, that for every project they put down for execution, Senatress Monica will actively get involved. Not only putting money there, but fiscally going out to make it happen. I personally have witnessed that. And when she is rendering this life of service, she does it with cheerfulness. You can see the genuineness and the sincerity in her heart.
5 decades after, Lady Monica remained a doting and dutiful wife, mother, grandmother, sister, auntie, friend and a community leader who became conspicuous due to her generosity and unrivaled kind-heartedness. She loved singing, dancing and reading. She committed and dedicated herself to the progress and well-being of family and humanity, especially to her husband who she supported with love, care and devotion. She was an exceptional, wonderful and beautiful heart whose presence graced lives with unwavering affection, enduring resilience and profound faith. Her kindness was a rarity and precious gift to all who knew her. She was a gem, an epitome of class and finesse, a woman of color, based on unrivaled culinary prowess, a signpost of excellence in motherhood, an Olympian in hours of unbroken communion with her creator, a Mother Teresa unclothed to the naked, a disciplinarian par excellence, whose product left indelible marks in their various fields of pursuit. Celebrating the loving and humanitarian strides of Rotarian Lady Monica Emesomate Alimihena, her 69 years on earth, birthed a life embossed and crusted in gold, and lighted with well-cut diamond stones, a lover of Christ, benevolent Christian and daughter of Mary Ever Virgin, a 24/7 loving and doting wife to Senator Francis, affectionate mother and extremely caring grandma. We know from the depth of our conviction that she dwells with the angels and sent in their celestial abode. Adieu, our dear senatress, Lady Monica Alimikena.
And found was black as sea. 'Twas grace that taught
I'm sure everybody enjoyed that performance. As you are aware, the president is unavoidably absent, Rotarian Jolomi. I am studying for him. I, Joseph Okakia, is the president-elect. So on behalf of the president, I will now read tribute to Chief Mrs. Onika Alimigena. Thank you for reminding me that the rain is over. I pray that it's over for today so that we have enough opportunity to finish this program. Chairman of the Planning Committee, my PD there. Representative of the DG ECI. Our whole chief host, Senator Francis Alimigena, fellow Rotarians and guests. This is the tribute, Mr. President. As a president of the Rotary Club of Abuja Metro, I owe the club and indeed the disease on a personal level the ability of writing a tribute in our honor. But to actually pen down something has been a challenge. How can one address Rotarian High Chief Monica Alimigena Ni Imomo in the past tense? A most difficult thing to do, we are ever consumed that she lived an exemplary gone ahead of us through a route all mortals must take. Rotarian Monica Alimigena was one of our best, a woman of substance and means, yet so humble. She had no reservations whatsoever in coming down to the level of people she came across, be they young, middle age, or of lower status. Fulfilling the biblical injunction, it is better to give than to receive. Act 20:35. She was at the forefront. She gave a treasure. She gave a time. She gave a talent. As a wife, she was a wonderful companion to the most distinguished Senator Francis Alimigena. Pillar, mobilizer, and manager of the home. She used her position to serve the interests of the less privileged, especially women and children of the entire Edo North Senatorial District, creating a larger than life image. She was felled by an illness that came suddenly. Even though it ravaged her body, she was still of sound mind and held her wits about her till the end. When we visited her on Monday, 17 July 2023, little did we know we were bidding her farewell. Today, on behalf of a grateful club, I say fare thee well. And the words of Shakespeare's Othello, may the flight of angels take thee to the eternal rest. Bye, our sister. Thank you. After this rendition, I will call on our district governor to give her own tribute, Rotarian Sagab Sani Ahmed. I'm sure he's represented by one of our DGMs. Okay, DGE. She's by our DGE who will not come to give his tribute on behalf of the district governor.
Oh, DG is here. Very good. May I have the honor of inviting the DJ to please welcome him first of all to this occasion. He's attending a program and he said he was going to break that program to
we have another special edition now by B Quartet. Are they ready?
this tribute. For the reason that for several evenings, when my wife and I come visiting, this is the arena where we end our visit, this same arena, or the same vicinity. Mrs. Salimi here now will come out with us, as usual, escort us out, and she will stand by that pillar by the far left, and there with my wife, they will start a new discussion. So I always wondered why that discussion couldn't have ended inside the house. And they were keeping waiting in the car, and I have to extricate my wife to come out for let's go. So it's really painful that I'm here this evening in the same arena to do this tribute. But I have to do it because the president has asked me to come and speak. These tributes will take three perspectives. I'll talk about her and the family. I'll go into Rotary. And, I'll then go to the general perspective of who she is. Mr. P.E., don't worry, I'll buy time. So don't worry about that. I'm going to buy time for you. In Rotary, we'll buy time if you want to speak additionally after the time given to you. Monica was a dogged and fearless supporter of my brother Francis Alimihela. From the name, you would think we are related. We are not related. She's the Momo, I'm the Momo. And that's where probably the bondness came about. She never called me by name. She always called me Uncle. I'm not even sure she knew how to call the name OC. But she was very, very close to the husband. You dare not cross the husband, and she will let you go. There was an incident that my wife witnessed where a guy had crossed the husband. And she was amazed the way Monica descended on that man. And when she got home and told me what happened, I said, yes, this is vintage Monica. She will not spare any person who crosses her husband. During the campaigns, she will wait behind and receive the husband. This multitude of crowd will follow them home, and she will feed, and I mean feed, virtually everybody. There was no discrimination between you are a big man or you are a small man. Everybody will be fed. That was the kind of woman she was. She had what I would call love for people irrespective of your status in life. Now, talking about her children, she was a doting mother, something we all know about, doting mother. From doting over my namesake, O.C., who is the youngest, to doting over John, who is 50 years old today, or 50 years old now. You wouldn't know that John is 50, the way she would dote over John. She was more or less like the proverbial mother hen, protecting her children all the time. Now, let's go to Rotary. When I was president of ARCAM, we had to build a hospital in Sauka, and I had a team led by the very respected president, Nodu. And we had this team, we were meeting every Saturday at Sauka site. And Monica and my wife were the purchasing officers. Can you imagine the wife of a ranking senator doing that for us? She was the purchasing officer of my wife. They will go out and do market survey, and then come back and go to Nodu and brief Nodu about what. And then after, Nodu would sign off on those things. So she was a very credible person. And honestly speaking, that's one of the things I think she has actually pushed over to her children. Then in Roach, like you had, she was the person, the main contact. If you wanted anything from my dear brother Francis, you go to her. All the investitures we've had since I came to Rotary, she would play a role in it. I don't know how she was doing it, whether she was tickling my brother by the ear or doing whatever, but she would actually ask for and she would give money to the investiture. On average, she was giving about ₦1 million each investiture for that. She loved Rotary. She loved Rotary. She has given us machines, that given us generators for our different projects. Now, she made a special impact before she translated. We were in the house and we got a phone call from her saying that Rotarians were in her compound, in the house, and that she had invited them into her bedroom. So I looked to my wife and said, what kind of love is this? How many of us here, we even allow people into our houses, talk less of taking them to the bedroom? So that will show you the kind of love she had for Rotary. Now, 2 days ago, I sat with my children on the dining table, and I said to them, because she loved my children, she did. I said, what will you remember about your auntie? They started giving all sorts of things, what you have all said, yeah, good woman, and all that. And then one said, Daddy, I will remember her for her smiles. Then the other one said, Daddy, I will remember her for her dancing. She was a good dancer. And that was true. Once the music is playing, you need to grab Monica to stop dancing. She will keep dancing and dancing. So my memory of Monica would be that smiling angel that is dancing with the saints. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Past President Osi Momo. You actually spoke that 2 minutes. So I may now reduce it to 1 minute so that. sorry, there is a red IODA card that is blocking an entrance, RSH 984AJ. Please go and remove your card. The next person now to speak is Rotarian Bosade Dupe Abosade. But I think I saw some of our members that came in. Abuja Metro is the biggest club in Africa. We have our former deputy speaker is here, Rotarian Okpara. Austin is here, you are welcome. I can also see the DG of Abuja Chamber of Commerce, Victoria Akai, and her sister, Mina Akai. I think they just came in. You're all welcome. Thank you.
My president, my DG, PDGs in the house, fellow Rotarians, friends and family of Rotary, the family of the deceased, good evening. No, it's just said 3 minutes before, but it's fine. I remember when we were having the committee meeting, they later told me I didn't know that this happened because that particular day I had issue with my network, the committee that puts this together, and they said who are going to be the ones to talk, and they somebody mentioned my name. In fact, about 2-3 people they said mentioned my name, and at some point they said, Dupe, don't let her come and talk. She will come and cry. And I'm going to surprise tonight. I'll try not to cry. All right. Without wasting much of our time, I'll just quickly say very few things. Mrs. Monica Halimekina. I have major things to say about her. The first one, so during my year as the president, she was a very good supporter of all my projects. In fact, I know at some point the senator will be wondering how, as in I got to, you know, have to come to his house and to get that much money from him. The wife was my channel. She was the one that would call Rotarian Elvis, Mona, they come. You don't just say enter, just say enter. This time is not like 9 p.m. At times to 11. I said, huh? And was like, Mona, they come, you just say enter. And it would just rush down. I would not leave here until after 1 a.m. Just there. And that's when you see Senator in his very simple man, as in way of doing things in life, just a very simple man. And right there, myself and Mama will like be looking at ourselves as in the time to talk. And Senator will say, I'll give you 1 million. And she will say, I should press order. I'll say, Senator, now, sir now. Say, okay, I'll give you 2 million. Mama will say, as in two more. She can't do more. I say, okay, sir now, thank you, sir. Say, okay, now, I'll give you 3 million. No, like that. And I was getting support from this family. And that same night, we talked about the foundation, and they also moved from level one by giving the club $15,000 to be a major level two. That I do not take for granted. I'll never forget you, Mama, for these things that you did. The support was too much. And I remember our Rotary life, even she was a very busy person, but she tried to conform it as much as she could. But very well, she would call while we were at the meeting, and she would say, Dupe, Nasi Dide, Ma we de, I de come. And she would rush down. Even if it was just a few minutes of it, she would rush down, even in a tight schedule. I remember one of the days she rushed down, and I saw Mama wearing something like a jean and a very beautiful top, you know, stoned and new. And with the trainers, Mama, what did happen now? He said, no behaviors. He said, make a lot of the wear boo-boo again. I said, hey, wait. You know, she was looking very smart and so beautiful. She said, make a lot of the dress that I called to my again, and let make me wear this one. I said, okay. What do, Mama? And that was who Mama was, so simple. And the second thing I'll quickly like to say about her was when we went to for this convention, the Rotary International Convention in Atlanta, and I was to stay for 2 weeks with some few Rotarians, and we were there, we finished the program, the convention, and we're still in the hotel spending money and all of that. And she was like, where on that day? Throughout the convention, we're going out together. And she was like, where? I said, yeah, I'm in this hotel. I was like, ah, no, I can't wear a day now. Rooms stay. And we went there, and we're just not just me. And she, people were going into their rooms, and she was like, drag my hand and pulled me into our room. Simple, humble. She's too humble for myself. And she, she was too humble for me. And she, we were sleeping on the same bed. We would not sleep. We were gisting. And that was when we became gist partner. We even got Nigeria. Mama would call me at 2 a.m., 1 a.m. That time she's very active, you know. And that's when she would pick her calls and send messages and all of that. And they would just would gisting. And that I still, Mama, I do not take for granted. For allowing me be on the same bed with you, to sleep on the same bed with you. Just Dupe. And the last one I'll say again was when we came here 17th July. Normally I bring my little pepper soup, and she was like, I never see somebody like you feeding a rich person and all of that. But that's 17th of July. We came and we were allowed in, and at some point we're at the living room downstairs, and at some point we just said, okay, we should come and see her upstairs, you know, which I know that we're not doing for everybody. And we went upstairs, and I saw her, like, oh, Mama, and all of that. And when we went downstairs, you know, to just still, you know, be with her for some time, we had to come downstairs. And I remember when she pulled my hands back, and she said, I'll be traveling tomorrow. First flight. I'm going to UK. And I remember she squeezed my hand when I said, Mama, you do not have a choice but to come back. And she said, yes, I will come back. And that moment she squeezed my hand, and I didn't know that was the last time I was going to see her. This woman, she'll be so missed. I just love her. May her soul rest in perfect peace.
Amen. Thank you very much, my past president. I thank you for keeping it to 1 minute and also not crying. Thank you. So, the first lady, Rotarian Gbemi Jolomi, I will not give you time, but I will give you reasonable time. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. I stand on the existing protocol for want of time. The very last time we came here officially for Rotary stuff was the day before she left for the UK. And when I saw her, I had my fears. But I was hopeful, though. I was hopeful. On the 31st of August, I woke up that morning to say my prayers, and as soon as I sat on my bed, a thought just came into me, very heavy in my spirit. I was so scared. You know why? Because anytime I have that feeling about anybody, the unthinkable happens. So I was so scared. I prayed for her, and there's this prayer link I sent to her every morning. I sent it though. And then we went to Yanya General Hospital for the maternal and child health project. When we got home, shortly after, I heard the news. I was confused. I was speechless. You know, I was just thinking, why is it that things like this happen? You know, for some days, I couldn't just wrap my head around the whole situation. And 4 days after her passing, I had a dream. I saw her in my dream. In the dream, they were having a party in this house. I don't know what the occasion was, but they were having a party, and she was seated in a faraway place, far from where other people were seated. You know how dreams are. But I understand the separation. Death has come, and she was on the other side. And then a lady, a young lady, walked close to her and said, "Ma, I don't have blouse to wear for the occasion." And she said, "Oh, no, go to my room upstairs. I have a drawer where I keep blouses. Go and take anything you want." That one left. Shortly after, a second person came and said she needed shoes. And she said, "Go to my room." I don't know whether we use the same shoe size though, but just go to my room and get yourself anything. A third one came and asked for ghillie. She sent the person upstairs too. And after the third person left, she turned and faced her husband, "Mr. Senator, sir," she said, "You see this good we are doing. Don't you ever stop doing it, because it pays." Maybe that's the message she wanted me to convey to you. When I woke up, as soon as she said that, I opened my eyes. And you see all those confusion, all those bitterness I had just stopped. I told myself, I'm not going to mourn her. I will celebrate her because I know she's in heaven. My spirit became light. I said, "See, I'm going to celebrate this woman. And I want all of us here to do the same. I think we should be thankful and grateful to God for sharing her with us for 69 years. That's quite generous. It's not enough for us, yes, but we should be thankful. Sir, I know she has left this very huge vacuum, and you'll be thinking, who is going to fill it? Just know that the Lord is by your side. He will always be there for you and the family. I understand your pain to an extent. My mother died in my arms 18 years ago. And when that thing happened, I thought it was the end. I would die. But here I am today. You know, what I know is, as the days go by, God has a way of easing it. God will ease it for you in Jesus' name. He will continue to comfort you and the family. He will give you strength where you need strength. My dear senatress, rest in peace.
Thank you. Thank you. District Governor, I think he's taking a leave. Like I told you, he came all the way from Kano. He must have one or two other occasions to attend in Abuja. That is the last person to speak from the club, from the Rotary Club of Abuja Metro. Before the other set of people that will give tribute, representing family of Rotarian Chief Mrs. Adley Migana, Monica, I will now call on the Qualitex. Is that Quartet? Are you ready? Okay. So after that performance, we have the other set of tributes. Thank you.
Tu segui con me, con me, con me. Time to say goodbye. Paesi che io non so. Con te partirò su navi per mari che non so, non esistono più. Con te io ne rivivrò, con te partirò. Navi per mari che non lo so, non lo esistono più. Con te io li vivrò, con te partirò. Mm.
Last night as I lay a-sleeping, there came a dream so fair. I stood in old Jerusalem, beside the temple there. I heard the children singing, and ever as they sang, methought the voice of angels from heaven in answer rang. Thought the voice of angels from heaven in answer rang.
Oh,
Thank you for that beautiful rendition. I will now call on members of the family that will give. But before that, I have one of us here who also want to quickly give his tribute before that. Please, you can come forward. Okay, that's John.
Distinguished Rotarian Senator Francis Ali McKenna and his family, the chief mourner, the ESA of Agini Bode, ladies and gentlemen, let me stand on existing protocols. I will say Mawade, that is how they say it in Agini Bode. In Asian, they will say Bodaye. In Benin, they will say Obotopwe. In my language, we will say Ndewono. Now, why am I saying this? I'm sorry, I've known Senator Francis almost 12 years, but I didn't get to get close to the wife, unfortunately. We met in Agini Bode. When in the course of duty, I was going to Uromi, and I decided to stay at Agini Bode. And a friend of mine brought him to my room, and then we struck a relationship. Then we'll come to the church, I'll see him. So, everything has been said up. Something to you. Don't speak to me about your religion. First show it to me in how you treat other people. Don't tell me how much you love your God. Show me in how much you love all God's children. Don't preach to me about your passion for your faith. Teach me through your passion, compassion for your neighbors. In the end, I'm not interested in what you have to tell me to sell, as I'm in how you choose to live. Gori Buka. As I was sitting here, I just saw. Now, this describes our late Rotarian Lady Monica Ali McKenna. I'm sorry to say I'm not as fluent as Elvis. Now, something again I did not too long ago about a friend of mine who passed on. I watched him die in the hospital, and that touched my life. I was in the village in Imo trying to bury him. And that's the first time I've gone to the East since this year because of all the things that are happening, plus my health. And I got this message. Lady Monica was dead. I said, what the hell? I tried to call some people because I found it. I said, look, maybe this was one of those fake news. Now, please, pardon me, oh, my Turinchi. Now, they right. Tonton Weda counsels the greatest tribute to the dead is not to grief, but gratitude. Furthermore, Alison Stanward admonishes, when they go and leave you, do not make a scent of the memory. Rather, remember them in honesty and let a smile play upon your lips and a tear moist in your eye. Like Mark Antony, we're not here to praise Lady Monica for all she had done. But we're here to console the family. The other day we were here, I remember that Senator is a retired soldier, an old soldier. And when he came out and somebody, for him to utter a word, tears were flowing. And when I got home, I told to my wife, I said, come. Look, this is life. By the time that was, my wife was somewhere undergoing a procedure and I couldn't just go. So in effect, what I'm saying, life is precious. The line between life and death is a thin line. So, distinguished, unfortunately, I'm coming to your house only on death. And what shocked me that the day we were coming, I was asking for the address. My driver said, okay, I know the place. I said, how did you know? He said, he brought one of the drivers that work here. I said, look at this man. So please, I mourn with you. Nobody can tell you that he knows how you feel. We can only console you and say, my brother, take him easy. On that note, ladies and gentlemen, may her good soul rest in peace. Amen.
Thank you, Rotarian John. I will now call on members of the families that will give their tribute. First is Rotarian Mrs. Aisha Doris Lekki. After that, we come Mr. Honorable John Alimikana, the first son of Chief Mrs. Monica. And the last to speak is the most distinguished Senator Francis Alimikana, the spouse. After that, we'll be going to the concluding part of this ceremony. So, Mrs. Aisha Doris, can you come forward?
Standing on existing protocol, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My senatress, I said I wasn't going to cry, but I was. She was a vicious lady. She was every inch a woman. That means she was beautiful, both in out, very accommodating, humble to the core, opened her doors for everybody, dutiful wife and standing by her husband. The distinguished, opened her door for me and my family, making the children to love me. I'm gonna miss her. We shared a unique relationship and a bond. She has other friends, but ours overshadowed a lot of the other friends. In our quiet times, we sit and discuss issues and laugh. And this is the only house, one of the houses, I mean just two or three, that I'll come and feel relaxed and I say, Senatress, I'm hungry. What do you have? She said, what do you want to eat? And they'll make the food for me. The husband also welcomed me, the children with open arms. I just have a blow. Two best people in my life the same month, my elder sister died. I had to come back to bury her. And the immediate, then my best friend and sister died. Wow. A week after we talked, and I said, I'm waiting. I will soon be going back. And she said, I'll be, well, and I said, if you don't come, I'm coming. She said, okay, we'll talk next week. That week, that was the week we never talked. It's still unbelievable. She was a swagalicious mama. Good dancer. Entertaining. She rocked. She was one of my pillars. Somebody I can count on. Oh, what does she want me to do? I'm sorry. Oh, I need you now. You have to come out of there. Well, it's okay. The Lord knows best. I cherished all the moments we had together. We did things together. She made me love going home. After the death of my parents, because I never grew back home, I never liked going home. She said, no, you have to go and know more about your people and the culture. I enjoyed, and they embraced me, welcomed me, expected me. And I enjoyed going with her. She takes me out. I'm not always around, but when I come, let's go to Rotary. Let's do this. I was once a full Rotarian, but due to some circumstances on my control, I had to keep, but she will keep pushing. She pushed me. I'm not the patient one. She's the patient one. She's saying, you have to accommodate people. Very accommodating. How? A good cook. I loved her cooking. I'll come, Sinitress, what did you cook? She said, for my husband. I said, I'm going to eat it. I know it's for daddy, but I need some. And she will give me she has a golden smile. A beautiful lady with a beautiful golden smile. And unassuming. How can I don't even know. I'm still not believing this. I'm still not believing. Wake me up. I'm dreaming. I wouldn't say may her soul rest. Her soul rest in peace, but she's still in my heart. My heart is broken. Two best people the same month. Wow. I don't know how to take this. I just want to that God will strengthen the husband and the children and myself. I just have to take it one step at a time to believe. I love you, love you, love you. That was the last word we said to each other a week before she passed. I said, I love you and I'm expecting you back. And she said she loved me more. I just want you to know, I really love and miss you. I can't believe this. Thank you all for listening. Swagalicious mom, you rock. Oh boy, I'm gonna miss you.
Thank you, thank you. That's Mrs. Doris Lekki. She is my first cousin. So in the absence of Mama, I will make you go home. I promise you. So, Honorable John Alimigana, first son, come and tell us what you know about your mother.
Everybody, I stand on existing protocol here. I've heard so much and so many things about my mom, and I want to thank everybody for participating over the loss of our mom. What can I say about my mom now? There are quite a lot to say. But because of time, I just want to be brief. Because if I start saying, I don't think I'll be able to speak. mommy was a gentle soul. Mommy taught me a lot of things. To be patient. To be humble. To be fearful of God. All these characters are embedded in her. I know that my mom lived for her husband, lived for her children, her grandchildren, even for the church and the youth at large. She's someone who taught me how to go to church. Italia, you always go maybe late mass. Always pushing me that let's go for 6 o'clock mass. So like that, every Sunday we are always going to church together. And we definitely cherish that and miss that. There's this saying in Pidgin that says, "Life no level." Now everybody will be wondering. I believe you all will believe what I'm saying, that somebody like the caliber of my mom would live a very long life. But when you propose, they say God disposes. That's what we are seeing here. May the good Lord grant our gentle soul. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Honorable John Alimigena. It was one time Vice Chairman of Itako East Local Government Council, our own local government. I think his junior brother is also here, who is now a colonel in the army. So Mama Monica is not just leaving us. He has very well outstanding children, both men and a daughter. I can see them all seated. So I think a good work will continue from where she stopped. So finally, I will call on the most distinguished senator from our senatorial district, Senator Francis Asikame Alimikana, to give his own tribute.
Good evening, my DG that I've just left, the past DG of Rotary, President of Rotary present here, all the Rotarians that are here, and non-Rotarians, and members of my family. I cried much. I will try not to cry so that the party will swing. I've just learned now that swagalicious woman, I will dance for you, oh my love. I don't know what to say. There are why. In the first instance, the Rotary should have told me that they go to make this place as beautiful as it is today. I would have invited my people. When they told me they were coming on the 21st, which is today, I thought it's just like how the other society were coming here. That's why I did not tell anybody. And I can tell you, this is my first time of stepping out today. I didn't know that all these decorations were done like this. Because I did sleep on time last night. I slept around 3 a.m. I came back from home yesterday. So because of this 21st, that people gave to me, I didn't know that it's going to be as beautiful as it is today. I would have invited my people to come and see the Rotary people, the good Rotary Club of Abuja Metro. I assure you, my wife died. It was me. Nickname my wife as senatress. The Rotary will not die in my family. I will continue to be members of Rotary to raise the spirits of my wife. So, I don't know what to say. I have to thank all of you, that able to hear today. People have spoken well about my wife. And if I want to talk about my wife, I will cry. I told them, look, my wife, I showed my wife, I said, look, I want to show this place is where they will bury me. And the place I told her they will bury me is where they are going to bury her now. And when she was, I said, look, I said, don't allow my people, my family people to mogul you or threaten you. Be bold. And I was telling her this because I thought I would die before her. I never knew she would die before me. If you bring about 30 dishes here cooked down, when I taste them, I know the one of my wife. And she was asking me, you don't want to go to Chinese. I said, what am I going to do there? What you are cooking is even more than that of Chinese. And then I go, okay, may God bless her soul. So if I had to talk about her, humble, I can now say that she's swagalicious. Swagalicious, smiling woman, beautiful woman, holy woman. God bless her soul. Thank you very much.
Thank you, distinguished senator. I know most of you that have spoken today are very emotional about what happened because it was not really expected. Actually, I didn't know, when I heard that she was sick, I didn't know it was something serious. I came with my Rotary members to see her before she traveled to UK, but I never knew that was the last time I would see her. I said, we are now winding down. I will call one of us, one of our elders to offer prayer to her. Okay, he still wants to add to that.
I forgot one thing. I want to take permission from the Rotary. I watched that people showed here. I have seen that what the Rotary did for her is even better than the one we did. I want to take permission from the Rotary that this one, this biography that people show here, I will take it to the village to play for our people to see that she was a Rotarian as well. So if you give me the permission, I will take it and play it there. This is what I want to take from you. And I will not do the one we play there. Thank you.
Thank you. I think your permission is granted. She was one of us, a respected member of our club. There is nothing within our control that we not do for her. So I will now call on our elder, a teacher per excellence, former member of the House, a writer and a past district governor, Rotarian Eddie Mbadiwe, to give a word of prayer. I think you can come here. Yeah? You want to stay here? Okay.
Past district governors, fellow Rotarians, and our friends, let me tell you one thing. If you do Monica, you will cry for her. Whether she was your family or not, you cry for her. Because she gets involved heavily in everything she has to take. But you also have to know for certain that in the next 1 month, all the tears will dry up. They will dry up. That is where you need God the most. Therefore, not coming to whip up your sentiments, I just want to say that God knows the best. After listening to that Jerusalem, you have no doubt that Monica is now with the angels and the saints. That should cheer you up. What we have come to show this evening as Rotary is that Rotary is fellowship and friendship. Fellowship and friendship. And she imbibed those virtues. Monica will not die in vain. I can assure all of you here. The Holy Scriptures tell us that we must weep with those who weep and dance with those who cry. And that's Rotary. Fellowship and friendship. Monica's legacy in our club will never die. She has very humble, very dutiful followers. The Bible tells us that blessed are those who weep, because they will weep no more. And God says that when you comfort those who are bereaved, you comfort yourself. And that he will never abandon you. God says he will send the Holy Spirit to be with you now and forever. And what can we ask God that he doesn't do? There's nothing. There's nothing. He knows everything before it happens. So please don't weep. Be of good cheer. Be of good comfort. Because blessed is he who the saints have found way to come home. But in that same spirit, I think we should ask the centuries of our club to stop her prayers. Her prayers are not bringing good luck. Only bring death. So please cancel those prayers in the interest of your family and in the interest of all of us here. We will never abandon Monica, and I hope the senator himself will never leave you. Because blessed is he who depends on the Lord, for they will never be made homeless. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you, PDG Eddie. We are gradually coming to the end of this program. For the last song, I will call on Rotarian Remy Daniels to, on behalf of Rotary Club of Abuja Metro, give a vote of thanks.
Testify that she was she beneficial to all of us? Yes, she was. On behalf of the planning committee of tonight's event and the president of the Rotary Club of Abuja Metro, every member of Rotary Club of Abuja Metro, the families of the Lamekenas, we like to say a big thank you to each and every one of you. The PDGs here, I want to say thank you to you. The DG in his absence want to say thank you to you. The past president, the guest, both far and near, family members want to say a big thank you to you. God bless you and good night.
That was the thanks by Remida. So before we declare this occasion closed, we are going to sing the last song, which is "To God Be the Glory." I will still call on Rotarian Kiro. Is she still there? Is she there? Okay. Is Jennifer there? Is First Lady there? We have women with good voices that we do justice to this. Thank you.
Please, let's be upstanding.
To God be the glory, great things He has done. So loved He the world that He gave us His Son, who yielded His life for redemption. Hey!
Thank you, beautiful ladies of Arkham. Once again, I thank everybody for taking part in this night of tribute. I now wish to declare this section closed. Thank you very much.